Und ich bin's wieder, okay, so neu heran, hier mit meinem Let's Play von Ace Attorney Investigation Prosecutor's Cast. Und jetzt, wo halt Dings, die zwei Vollnasen, Roland und Blaze, endlich mal hier schön seelisch fertig gemacht werden, Sebastian jetzt, weiß, was er zu tun hat in seinem Leben, geht es erstmal jetzt weiter mit dem Fall, wer den Präsidenten von Sengfa umgebracht hat, und scheinbar weiß John etwas. Na dann. I wasn't feeling too great during yesterday's shoot, so I made a few bloopers. They're reshooting the scene today, so... Well, I decided to rehearse a little on my own, that's all. I do it all the time. There wasn't anything out of the ordinary. You were rehearsing alone that late at night? John, when I called you last night, you told me you were at the hotel. You called him? About what time was that? I believe it was around 11 PM. I require him to call me every night. That's our rule whenever he stays away from home. The truth is, I was at the film lot during that time. Oh. So you lied to me. You lied to me. You're dead to me. I'm sorry. Miss Courtney sure is angry. Natürlich macht sich halt Sorgen um ihren Jungen. I think it's admirable that he practiced on his own, even if he hid it from his mom.
I'm sure she was simply worried. Who knows what could have happened to him out alone so late at night.
Genau, nachts lauern ja jetzt neuerdings die Killer-Clowns oder irgendwelche Perversen. Mörder, Vergewaltiger, es hätte alles passieren können.
And in reality, he did get caught up in yesterday's incident.
But John said there wasn't anything out of the ordinary, right?
Is that really the truth?
Lass doch mal gucken. Oh, hups! Entkräftung! Johns irgendwas. Rehearsal war das, glaube ich. Egal.
Also da war nichts, sagte er. Wenn ich jetzt das noch finde, wie ich wollte. By himself, Monster's footprints can be seen. Ja gut, er verschwindet. Aber hier, diese Footprints sind noch da.
There wasn't anything out of the ordinary. That's a lie, isn't it? We have evidence right here.
Could that be?
That's right. It's the video you recorded of your performance. What? You're telling me you have video from last night? Exactly. And in this video, there is clearly something that is out of the ordinary. This is a monster's footprint!
Would you say that monster's footprints are commonplace on a film set?
John, what did you conceal this video from us?
No reason, really.
Hey, pup, this is not joking matter. You had a reason to hide it, right? John Marsh, answer him clearly.
But Mom...
Well? I didn't want anyone to see me rehearsing.
Oh, hat sich der Kleine geschämt, oder was?
In other words, you're embarrassed about others seeing you practice.
Yeah, got a problem with that?
You're saying that's why you hid the evidence?
John! Eep! Quit nagging me! You've already busted me, what more do you want?
Yeah, the footprints were there, but I just practiced and had it home. How come you're so calm after finding those footprints? It's a monster, you know? A real-life monster. I thought it was just a part of the set. Besides, there's lots of other weird stuff around here too. He's suspicious, Chief. This kid's really suspicious. Yeah, right. The smell of a scoop stinks to high heaven. Shut up. We're done talking. Objection. We're not done here yet. What now? The monster's footprints weren't the only unusual thing that's happened last night. Besides the monster's footprints, what other unusual thing happened last night? War es auf dem Video zu sehen? Ja gut, ansonsten, wie war das denn bitteschön? Der fallende Kopf? A monster's head fell from the roof of that building. Surely you must have known about that. I don't know anything about it. Is that true? I told you, I just practiced a bit and then I went back. I don't know anything about Muzilla's head falling or anything like that. Or do you have evidence to show that I know something? There certainly isn't any evidence of that. It's also possible that it fell after John had already gone back. If there's no evidence, then like I said, we're done talking. It seems that John doesn't really want to talk about last night. Could he be hiding something after all? Wait up! Agent Lang? It's as I thought. Thank you, Mr. Prosecutor. This video backs up my logic. Huh? Is there something in the video that's related to the case? Yeah, take a good hard look at the monster costume in the top left. The Muzilla costume? Try comparing it with the one over there right now. It looks like it's just hanging there limply though. And the zipper on its back is zipped up tight. Tightly. Well, zipper on its back? What? This discrepancy is... Yeah, the difference is plain to see. In the video, the zipper is clearly open. That's right. Someone was inside. What? Mr. Powers, is the costume zipper unusually... It's always zipped up tightly when it's not in use. Mr. Prosecutor, do you remember? My logic from before. Two nights ago, Courtney pushed the president off the roof and killed him. Afterwards, she snuck into the film lot to hide the body. In here? Wouldn't it be easy to hide a body in a costume or behind all this equipment? Then all she had to do last night was retrieve the body. You're saying the body was hidden inside the costume? Yeah, that's right. Judge Courtney, two nights ago you pushed the president off the roof of the tower. You then hid the body inside the monster costume. I didn't know such thing. Say what you want, but you're the only one who could've done it. Objection. That should have already been proven impossible. The film lot was locked at the time. Judge Courtney could not have entered this place. And what if there was an accomplice? What? I'll tell you my reasoning, so listen up. Okay, jetzt bin ich mal gespannt. Erstmal ein schwere Tasse. Eher ein Schluck. Oh, ist das noch heiß? Okay, jetzt bin ich gespannt. When the president was pushed off the roof, John was waiting at the film lot. If John was an accomplice, the problem with the locks would be resolved. The two of them then hit the president's body. I tied that monster costume over there. Ernsthaft? Ernsthaft? You think this crime had such an elaborate plan? To take the life of a nation's president. An elaborate plan is to be expected, don't you think? John would never take part in such a crime. You're the one being suspected. Your words don't carry much weight. I wouldn't think those two had sufficient motive for something like this, though. Well, maybe they had a motive that we didn't know about. You were the last one to meet with the president, and you're still keeping the details secret. Don't you think it's only natural that you're being suspected? Judge Courtney, is there no way for you to tell us your secret? I apologize. I just cannot, no matter what. However, when the time I can talk about it comes, I will surely let you know. So, if you could please...
Believe you? Is that what you wanted to say? That's what all criminals say. And you, pup, if you've got an explanation, hurry up and spit it out.
I didn't do nothing. That's all I'm saying.
Both mother and son won't talk. You're still gonna defend him like this?
It's true, Judge Courtney's actions are a mystery. However, we still don't know whether or not that ties in a motive for murder.
Yeah, that's right. Their motive for murder can wait.
For now, let's talk about the situation surrounding the crime. And the fact that these two are the only ones who could have done it.
Wer will die zwei aber auch unbedingt ins Kornfeld nehmen? Keine Ahnung, ob das jetzt so richtig ist, aber das ist jetzt das Einzige, was mir gerade einfällt. Denk an meinen Braid Lag, denk an meine Erkältung. Ugh.
Na dann. Entkräftung! Mother and Son Theory.
Wollen wir doch mal sehen.
In the video, we cannot see the inside of the costume. So can you really say for certain that the body was placed inside?
Yeah, I'll give you that much. In that case, why don't we try examining it?
The inside of that costume. There might be some traces left inside. Mr. Powers, may we examine the inside of the costume?
Sure, go ahead. But it might be kinda stinky, since I sweat a lot in there.
It's okay.
This is incredibly dirty.
That's strange. We always make sure to clean it after using it, so that the sweat doesn't damage the costume.
Isn't this just proof that someone besides you used this costume?
It's say that dirt from the body probably got into the costume.
The president's body did fall on top of the monster's footprints. That must be where the dirt came from.
Are you satisfied now? There's dirt inside the costume. It must have gotten there when the body was hidden inside.
Let's see. Well, it works.
Dirt got onto the costume when the body was hidden inside. Is that really the case?
You have a problem with that?
There is a fair amount of dirt inside the front of the costume.
Yeah, that is a lot of dirt.
However, I would like you to focus on the state the body is in. It's lying on top of the dirt, and yet there's no dirt on the front of the body. If the body really was inside the costume, then it's strange that the front of the body isn't stained with more dirt.
Well then, how would you explain it? How did the dirt get inside the costume?
From the video footage, it's very likely that someone was inside the costume. But just who could it have been?
Where have I seen this?
What's the matter, Kay?
I just felt like I remember seeing something that looked like this dirt somewhere before. But where was it? There were these bits of gray fragments mixed in with the dirt.
Gray fragments? There does seem to be something other than normal dirt mixed into it.
Something must have gotten stuck up to it, and lots of it might add...
Something got stuck into it? This may merit a closer look. Where did we see dirt that looks like what's stuck on the inside of the costume?
Moment.
This dirt has some gray bits mixed into it.
Huh? And what of it?
We found an item belonging to a certain man that was covered in the same type of dirt. That is to say, these gloves. Those dirt stains certainly looks the same. But tell me, just what exactly is this gray substance? This gray substance is... Ich weiß jetzt gerade nicht, was konkret bedeutet, aber es, was es auch ist, es liegt näher als Plastik oder Farbe. Glaube ich mal. Ansonsten, ich kann ja irgendwie mal googeln.
This gray substance must be fragments of concrete.
You mean the stuff that was scattered around the monster's footprints?
Exactly. Ach, dieses Asphaltding oder was? Heißt das so?
Meanwhile, who do these gloves, which are stained with the same kind of dirt, belong to?
Oh, I remember! We found it at Blaze's place!
Earlier today, we went to Blaze's garage. There were discovered these dirt-stained gloves. Come to think of it, there were also hammers, shovels, and other tools placed inside as well.
Why would mechanic's glove intended to be used on machines be covered in dirt?
If you broke the concrete with the hammer, and then dug into the soil with the shovel, then it's only natural for dirt like that to get on the gloves.
Then maybe...
Yes, the true nature of the monster's footprints has been made clear. It's possible that these footprints were dug up by Blaze the Best himself. It's possible? It's possible, you say? Please do enlighten me. 'Cause I honestly have no clue. Why on earth would he do something like that?
Why did he make the monster footprints? Thinking about it, the answer must be...
Hat was ausgegraben? It's possible he was digging something up. It probably went something like this. Last night, at this spot, there was something that Blaze needed to dig up. For that reason, he broke the lock on the back door and sneaked into the film lot. Using the hammer and shovel, he set to work.
He placed the items he dug up into his bag, but before he could fill in the holes...
Ah, that's when John came to practice!
Exactly. Blaze panicked and had to choice up... had...
Entschuldigung.
And had no choice but to hide himself in a Mozilla costume nearby.
To think you would deduce so much from just a pair of dirt-stained gloves. However, all of this is merely a possibility. There's still no proof that he was the one who was hiding inside that costume. For all we know, he might have left the scene once he finished the digging. On the contrary, such proof does exist and can be seen in the video. When this video was recorded, Blaze was definitely inside the film lot. What? Though I can't blame Agent Long for not noticing. The difference between the current film lot and the one in John's video, along with the state of Blaze's garage. It's all too clear that Blaze was still here. Wieso wurde jetzt hier das Bild von Dings gezeigt? Von dem vierten Sebastian? What proves that Blaze was still at the film lot when this video was recorded?
So, dann... Was?
Lass mal gucken. Aua, mir tut jetzt irgendwie hier was an den Achseln weh. Ah! Stop it!
Moment. War es vielleicht hier diese Barsche?
This bag placed near the costume. There was an identical one inside Blaze's garage. First the dirt on the gloves and now the bag. It seems there's a connection. And that's my proof. Blaze was inside the costume. Ergo, the president's body could not have been hidden inside it.
Ayo!
It seems I was able to refute Agent Lung's reasoning.
Someone needs to go investigate Blaze's house right away, pal. We need to know what was inside that bag.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
You pipe down and listen up! You've just been saying that whatever works best for y'all.
And the noisy one returns.
That there's the footprints of the mighty Mozilla. There ain't just some random holes dug up by that old coot.
I believe the true nature of these footprints has already been proven quite logically.
Logic schmogic. I ain't buying it. Say what you want, but I know what I saw, and I saw Mozilla.
Is she referring to how she saw Mozilla out the window of the Grand Tower? Preposterous.
Open your journalist soul! We ain't having none of it!
That statement is an insult to journalists everywhere.
Ah, that's right. There's more to them monsters than just those footprints. I remember hearing that Sunny over there was seen with the monster earlier. I reckon that girl over there said she witnessed it herself.
When these two are together, all meaningful talk grinds to a halt.
If we only knew just what the monster really was, I think those two would quiet down.
Oh yeah, bitte. Langsam, ich muss selber gestehen, langsam wird's nervig.
Mr. Edgeworth, isn't there anything you can do?
The monster's true identity?
Ich glaube, an dieser Stelle werde ich den Part jetzt erstmal beenden. Egal ob positiv oder negativ, wer hat immer gern gesehen. Der Großmeister, also wir sehen uns das nächste Mal wieder. See ya, guys.